Day. What's good, everybody? Welcome to the space of divine energy. Welcome to this beautiful channel. Seeing wellness on your journey, as you will need it at some point. All right, or at least you're gonna run into it over here. Anyways, let's get into the messages. Hopefully, I can help somebody out. What's good, everybody? New and old. I love you. If you're returning, you already know what it do. What's good, baby, baby? Oh, and I want to say thank you to everybody that, you know, be over here chilling with me, because I fuck with y'all. I love y'all. All right, for real. That's real. But, They be like, Okay, so who this? I think the last one I did was Sedge. Let me just take a quick peek into my notes. Yeah, so we got Sedge out there. Let's do Gemini. This one gonna be for Gemini. So this one gonna be Scorpio. Holy Spirit, angels and guides, what is this message here? Show me what I need to see. Holy Spirit. Alright, Gemini, come through. What is your messages here for Gemini during this space, this time? For everybody that's gonna watch this message, for Gemini. For Gemini. I don't know who I said in the beginning, but it's for Gemini. I think I didn't know whether I wanted to do Scorpio or Gemini, but this message is for Gemini. It's telling me this one for Gemini. Okay, let's get into it. What I'm seeing right here, right on the top, is Gemini, you dodged a bullet or some shit like that. Okay. Now, it could be energies that's upset about that shit. The fact that you dodged a bullet. Some of you ain't let affect you or something like that. You averted some sort of disaster. Some sort of trouble, difficulty, something like that. People could still be trying to hold on to your energy. We got Capricorn, Gemini, Aquarius, Sagittarius. It's kind of like, right now I'm getting for you, Gemini, it's like, this situation where someone want to keep you stuck, you might feel stuck. especially in a connection, I feel like there could be something better. I feel like eventually you find that. If you let go of something from your past that had the potential literally like to ruin you or deceive you, trick you, steal from you, something like that. Signs I'm getting out here. We got Leo, Pisces, Virgo, Cancer, Taurus, Pisces again. So this could be a relationship. This could be a person, you know, so something like that for some of you guys. I feel like you letting go of somebody and you know, like it's for the best. This person just is very manipulative or something like that. Like, sneaky, a liar, all this dumb shit. You may have figured this person out and just let this person go. Simple as that. But it may be a little bit more complicated than that. Like, maybe you got kids or something that's holding you in a situation. Or you may feel obligated to this person, this connection for some reason, right? Just because of the way that your values or the way that you see yourself with people, like, you know, but whatever. I feel like there's a better connection coming in here at some point. But that's also contingent on you letting go of something in your past here when it comes to this hurt, this pain, this person. Somebody's deceptive, tricky, slippery. They think you don't know something, you haven't figured them out, and you have. Gemini. What's coming out for Gemini? What's this Hierophant energy? So we got masculine energy here, clarifying the Hierophant. Okay, and it's saying the most difficult part of this situation is over, yeah. No, my elbow just knocked over. The Emperor and the Magician, yeah. Ooh. Somebody. We got a Divine Masculine and they're masculine. Somebody's like, I don't know. I'm getting like, you stop going, like, deciding to go, like, when somebody go low on you, you decided to stop going low with their ass. You decided, like, fuck that. That's not helping me. Something like that. I'm getting that for you, Gemini. And it's really what's helping you clear out something that's difficult in the situation. That's why I say the most difficult part is over. It's saying honor and respect will come to you. Okay, despite whatever going on, because you detaching, you pulling back your energy. So it's like you taking away this person's power because they never had no power. Only the power that you gave them. What's Knight of Wands? We got our grapes. Time to go out and have fun, Gemini. Okay, passion, I see you having fun. Enjoying your life, getting back out there, okay? Situations in the balance that require careful handling. Yeah, just really self-care. Just really minding your business. Like, taking care of you. Doing the things that matter to you. Again, just that whole pulling back your energy and putting it back where you need to be, which is in yourself. What's Seven of Swords? Yeah, this path, I feel like, or this chapter that you was in for you, Gemini. It may have been difficult, but I feel like you mostly focus on your material wealth and your spiritual growth. We have significance in February also. So there's something about a lie or some sort of deception that may have came out in February. What else? What's this Ten of Swords in reverse? The Moon. Yep, changes in your life. Yeah, because you avoided some sort of disaster. Pay attention to your work. Yeah, pull that energy back towards yourself. What's the Four of Pentacles? We got significance in November and Barrel. You feel something is lacking in your life, Gemini. Maybe love, money, or goals. And that's what I feel like this person was distracting you maybe from that. And so now, like, letting this person go, now you get to focus on your life, your goals, the things that's for you. You also got a parrot. Someone gossiping about all your secrets in November. So just, I don't know, maybe keep your business to yourself or something like that. Or just know that if somebody know your business, they want to talk about it or they want to gossip. Like, somebody want to bring you down as the energy or some shit. What's the strength? We got bull. Okay, so they saying don't back down from this opposition. So strength and fortitude. You got the bull clarifying the strength card. Okay. Like, so it's imperative that you don't let this person think that you they won. But at the same time, like, I don't really feel like you should argue with nobody. Like, it's just already a thing. Like, you already won something. Like, this is how I feel. By withdrawing your energy or withdrawing whatever power that you gave them. You know what I'm saying? Real shit. Hand. In need of help, assistance, or guidance. Maybe this person was in need of something and you, whatever you gave them with hand. What's the Ten of Cups in reverse here? You will be shown the way. Okay, so some of y'all might not know how you're going to figure this out with moving forward or whatever it is that you're doing. Even if it's not about, you know, this reading isn't about a person for you, but more so a situation. You're going to be shown the way. Okay. And we got a man keep coming out here. Masculine energy is very significant here. Gemini reading. What's culmination? Yeah, see, clarifying the Ten of Pentacles here. Plenty of material things. Bold. And you also got out and working, achievement, and success. Yeah, I feel like it's all in focusing on your goals, your prosperity, your work, things like that. It's just really a season of prosperity for you, Gemini. And if you just, like, kind of focus on that versus these failed attempts in relationships, you know, might be very successful for you this year. Okay, if you could do that. What's the Two of Cups here? I also see, like, another person or, like, somebody that really love you. Something that's more genuine coming in. You got mice, discord among family or friends. Two of Cups. This could be, like, beliefs or ideas that you have around connections. We got out fingers warning you of a problem either now or in the future. An arrogant, boastful person you should not cross. Okay. So, I don't know if this is, they saying this is you. They saying this is you, the rooster, Gemini. I don't know. Arrogant, boastful. I don't know. Is they saying that's you? This could be a problem in the future, maybe. I don't know. Causing discord among family or friends. Something about self-sabotage I'm getting here. Be aware of it. Okay. Between connections. Something about things being good and then sabotaging it because you just kind of used to shit, kind of going to shit all of the time, you know? And kind of not going back in that circle, but pulling yourself through so that you can have more healthier experiences for my Gemini. Let's see. And connections. What is the Chariot? So maybe shadow work might be coming up for you, Gemini, something like that. I'm hearing boats, money, or property through an inheritance, winning, or a windfall. Some of you guys gamble, I'm hearing, with this boat, clarifying the Chariot. Some of you guys, this is through your own hard work, dedication. Some of you guys, this may be an inheritance, something you win. You win, yeah, something like that. Let me get, what's this Chariot energy? get back to the basics. What is that? Chain of events that's affecting your, that will affect your life. What's that for Gemini though? More specifically, here. Thank you. Broken ring. Parting in ways in either romance or business. This could also speak of you like working for yourself for some of my Geminis at some point. You got out flute, disappointment in a friend or a lover. Then you got torch, spiritual development, enlightenment, awareness, and understanding. I feel like that's your biggest, you know, focus at this time. Like a big focus on your increase in material wealth and your spiritual growth. That's just where you at right now. Despite whatever disappointment in romance, friends, that's creating these chain of events towards your spiritual development. Okay. It's like you're not taking nothing really personal too much these days. I mean, it's like you, it's a part of the, what you have to go through, right? It's a part of life. What's this Ace of Cups? Broken wishbone. Damn. It's like, Gemini, you really gonna have to like be mindful, like not being wishy-washy moving forward. Like, be really secure in what it is that you desire. That's what I'm getting here with this broken wishbone. Because if something's not granted to you, it's because you just allowing, you're not allowing, you know what I'm saying, it to happen. It's like kind of like you're forcing something. So just be aware of that. And the quicker like you could figure that out, right, it becomes like a temporary problem to where, you know, you could have the wishbone instead of it being broken. Because the opposite of this card is the wishbone, where the wish is granted. So see what I'm saying? So like, kind of be mindful of like working against yourself at this time too, moving forward from my Geminis. Let's get some more messages here. Let's clarify the Two of Cups here. What is the Two of Cups energy about? Thank you. Okay. We got the Four of Wands in reverse. Yeah, something really feels imbalanced, or you're not happy in a certain type of connection. Maybe this person was what it was, or this situation was what it was, or what you wanted it to be at some point, and now it's not. I feel like being realistic will really help you out right now. Okay. Clarifying the Chariot. What's the Chariot energy here? You got the Star in reverse. I feel like believing yourself, you know, trust yourself more. I feel like that's what's really like where you at right now on your spiritual development path. It's about trusting yourself right now, and like you deepening that for yourself right now. Gemini, yeah, with the Two of Swords. Just finding your way, Gemini. What is that? What's the higher state for Gemini right now? What's the higher state? We got a Nine of Wands. Something's felt, it feels like you've been dealing with a challenge or some sort of difficulty or something like that for a minute now or something. What's the Knight of Wands? We got the Ten of Wands in reverse. I also feel like whatever you've been dealing with, like, it's getting better. It's like, it's not, it's a temporary problem. Gemini. Clarifying the Seven of Swords. got this. What is this? Ooh, can I see? Three of Cups in reverse. I feel like a lot of people are not happy, like, with this new shift or where you are, like, on your spiritual development. I feel like you got to get more secure in, like, your game or something like that. Like, where you are, you know, something like that, and less comparative or something. I'm also picking that up for those of you. I don't know why I'm picking that up, but this could be definitely, though, related to career. For some of you guys, Gemini. What's the Ten of Swords in reverse? Eight of Swords. Yeah. Somebody wants you to be blocked, Gemini, or like trapped. And I feel like you're releasing this person or letting this person go. Or the situation, whatever it is, that got you blocked or wants you to feel that way. I feel like you feel the energy of what it wants you to feel, the opposition, right? But I feel like you're using it like for your good, you know, if that makes sense. It's just with this Eight of Swords, something wants you to feel like stuck here or blocked. What's this Four of Pentacles? Got a King of Swords. You could be feeling detached lately, Gemini, here with the King of Swords energy, or just like real don't want to deal type shit or something to that effect. Like, I don't know, something lacking. I don't know what this energy is. Something to that effect. It could also just be like your passions, like burning down or something like that. So just being mindful of your energy consumption and distribution. What's the strength? Clarifying the strength. You got the Ace of Wands. Yeah. A new relationship or a new something here. There's something new, believe it or not. And it's kind of like the more that you release your past or something from your past, the more that like you can kind of enjoy that or experience that. I keep getting that as well for you, Gemini. Clarifying the Fool with the Magician. I don't know, that's just what I'm getting for you. Also, I just pick up too, like, somebody's very manipulative. Like, they try to do it, like, in a very subtle way or something like that. Or, it's like, somebody just, like, really hates the fact that it's you or something like that. I don't know why. I'm just, that's what I'm picking up for you, Gemini. It's like, it could have been anybody and it would have been like, oh, that was whatever, right? But because it's you, kind of like, it's like, you know, it could have been anybody. And they would have been happy for them. But it's like, because it's you, they not. Something like that, almost. We got the Ten of Cups here in reverse. What is that? Yeah. Ten of Pentacles. They see you as more successful. People see you. Whoever these energies of opposition in your life, Gemini, they see you as more successful than them. So if people give you a hard time because you're more successful than them. And I feel like you paying these people dust, that's really ultimately your superpower, your flex right now. And if you feel like things aren't going your way, it's just because, you know, perspective, hello, overall. Because I feel like you're winning something or you have an advantage here, Gemini. Despite the way things might you know, be perceptually. Also, I feel like you just developing a lot right now, spiritually and material wise. There's a connection getting ready to happen here. We got the Lovers clarifying the Ace of Cups. So, again, these are temporary problems, whatever you are facing, Gemini. Okay, strongly what I'm picking up here. All right, yeah, you got Five Pentacles to the Nine of Swords in reverse. These are temporary problems. But yeah, this is what I'm getting for you, Gemini. Let me know how you like this one down below. Peace.